morning, everyone. Not sure how much you can see because it's still dark. It's 5 a.m. We are already in the bivouac. Philip is preparing currently. And I'm just about to finalize the checklist of the bike. Just seeing the start times, they didn't change. So looks like we're on track. It's let me switch on the light over here. So looks like we are on time 5:46. Yeah. Everything looks good. So there are just some final touches left, like checking the camel bag that he's carrying. It's already done. I think everything is okay. It was a rough morning to wake up too early. How do you feel?
Me?
Yeah.
On the one hand, I feel ready for it and ready to go, but on the other hand, I'm half asleep and it's early start, 4:05. I woke up this morning. I've got all the protection on, so far some protection. It's so far worked really well last year and this year, so we'll see you in a bit, okay? Just take it steady today, hopefully, and just focus on the navigation.
There's the bike. He did great yesterday. You're gonna do greater today. All right, we'll check in a little bit later today. We have some preparation to do still. See you guys. Just walking to the starting point. It's still kind of dark. Ooh, we are like 2 minutes from the start. We just made it because there was some other complication going on. Going to the toilet this morning, yeah. So, but he's just right over there. I'll flip the camera. There you go. Much better. 5:44. Holy moly. Alright, anyway, the only thing that matters is that we are on track. Here are the guys queuing up already. And there he is. After Philip left early morning, I went back to the hotel and edited two videos, the day 3 and the GoPro only. But I'm not sure if I have enough time to upload the GoPro only because I have to jump into the car and start driving to the remote bivouac. On my way to remote bivouac, I had to go through the Rio Bridge, which is a really beautiful bridge with absolutely stunning scenery. So my drive was quite smooth. Let's see what happened to Philip meanwhile.
Hey guys, I've got about 1.5 minutes left before I finish the 90 minute neutralization. Lots of damage on the lens, but a few navigation issues this morning, and also a fuel leak on the front left hand side, which I could smell. So I've had to sort those pipes out. You can't really see, we'll show you later. Okay, I've got to go. I set off in 1 minute 15 seconds, still need to clean my goggles. That's the kind of view. Just waiting. Okay, bye. Arrived back. It's been good because I'm here and I'm safe, but it's been bad for navigation, crashing, wrong instructions from the organisation. So I'm sure they're going to move all the time times around and give people a load of penalties. Probably they just do a neutralisation, but they should be giving penalties. So I lost about, I don't know, 20 minutes or something. Everyone overtaking me because I stuck to the rules that they were told on the course. The damage is not looking good. Well, bike is still rideable, but Adam has just noticed the bash plate is totally cracked through here in two pieces, down and across down here. Luckily I've got another one in the camper, in the car. Took a big chunk out of the tank here at the front. The fuel line here started to leak, so I had to disconnect that when I got to the fuel station, so I'm only running on the rear tank now. Luckily I could switch it over. But the worst thing that I've got to worry about, or all of this bash plate hitting the tank, something's badly gone wrong here.
Yeah, it looks like the whole bash plate is loose. Can you move it here? No, sorry, the tank. Yeah, that one.
I can smell a lot of fuel.
Yeah, and also here,
yeah, that's
just popped out, the whole thing, yeah.
But there's something wrong with the tower.
Is it your frame? No, that cannot be. I see the whole front moving.
Every time I go over the rocks, it makes a bad noise.
So, how is it going, sir?
I've had better days, but I rode very well. I'm happy, but
you were a little bit pissed in the beginning.
I was very pissed because there was some strange organisation instructions going on.
Nobody followed the rule. I mean, not everyone, right?
Yeah, and so I was going 30 kilometers an hour for about 20 kilometers, and other people just shooting past.
Yeah, so regarding that, we filed a complaint. Hopefully they are looking into that.
But the biggest thing is the tanks. You can see the bash plate is now rubbing against the tank on this side. On the other side, it's miles away from the tank. The bash plate is broken. So I really need to see what's been going on. There was a couple of big crashes. Hard on the big rocks.
Well, we found why the tower is moving. Look over there. You crashed on the left side then,
yeah.
Right? So he crashed the left side. There is a gap now here. And on the other side, if you check it, there is no gap. So this part is actually not touching this surface. So the whole tower becomes not rigid because of that part. It's not laying on there. Well, well, well. I don't think the zip tie is gonna help anything.
I was hoping to.
It's just gonna cut the plastic, it's aluminium.
The thing is, I can't really think of a better solution.
I think we should play the MacGyver music here. So apparently the seat is stuck now here. So what I told Philip he can do is just zip tie the thing in the air.
We just don't want to take it off.
Yeah, if you take it off and you cannot put it back, that's gonna be the problem, huh? Nice and clean, crunchy air filter. Baked ready from the oven. Oh, and it worked, you see? Yeah. So this is how you trash a 25,000 euro bike, or how much? Let's take it to the rally. Philip, I have good news.
What?
It's only 413 kilometers tomorrow.
Thanks, I need to fix this, man. It's gonna take us probably all night.
So, Philip has a lot of fun here. His funny mustache.
I'm still waiting for a wet towel from my service crew.
There is no service today. The only place where you can get a service is gonna be the hotel. So apparently there's a way to fix the tank again. Which is kind of interesting, but it's gonna work out, right?
Yeah, I've got a bolt through now. I'm gonna put a nut on the inside. Hopefully I can reach.
But can you not crash it tomorrow, please? So Philip is doing the final touches on the bike. Everything is okay and going good. We're going to be ready for tomorrow. I hope you guys like this day, this very challenging day, and see you on day 5.